rest.
Yeah.
He's putting it in.
Oh, right.
Yeah, so it's probably best to leave it running, actually. Yeah. Red dot, I mean, recorded, just fast up record there.
Okay.
Okay. So, front end, I'm assuming that you had a gas, a pigtail with a gas regulator attached to the van, or was it a regulator on the gas itself?
Regulator was attached inside the two tails.
That's it. Well, this one, you got a single one. That's your, probably similar then, I would expect. That's your regulator is attached to the van there, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah. So you'll just need a pigtail there to operate off whichever gas you're going to use. I'm not sure which gas you have got.
Calor.
Yeah, it's propane or butane, red or blue?
Red.
So you're going to need to get one of them. So it's similar to that one I've got on there, because obviously I've got my gas on there at the moment.
Yeah.
You also need to fire everything up. There's a few things in there. You've got a wheel lock in there, it's also got a waste tank. Obviously came with it originally.
Yes.
Other bits and pieces, you've got your wind handle there, and you've also got fridge vents in there as well.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. What's the yellow in there?
I think there's an extra wheel lock in there as well.
Okay.
So it's got a proper alcohol wheel lock.
And your basic wheel lock.
Uh-huh. Front end, I'm going to say, should be any different, I would have thought.
Yeah.
Apart from you've got an ATC. Perhaps you probably didn't have that on your own day.
We didn't.
No.
So ATC.
ATC, it's like automatic trailer control. What it does is detects movement. So you get a bit of a snake on. It detects that movement. All it does is slowly applies the brakes.
Yeah.
And you imagine a car and a caravan going like that.
Yeah.
Slows the caravan down and the car just pulls it straight.
Yeah.
So it's a safety system.
So it's like an old snake.
Yeah, it's anti-snake. It'll detect it obviously as it starts, and then all it does is pulls back on the brakes to line it back up again.
Yeah. And we don't think our orange thing that we had on there before will fit.
Yeah, did you have different? Well, the old Alco.
What, the side winder?
No.
Or the one with the red handle?
So,
you want to see what you can't see. If you have the red handle with the loop, and it's see-through there, and the loop here, that should be exactly the same there. So it may fit that.
Right, but okay, well, we'll try it.
Okay, then apart from that, everything else is the same, I would think. Obviously, Jaguar is a bit more substantial, probably, because you've got a nose weight gauge on there as well.
Yeah, how does that...
So it's just when you've got the weight on it, it will show you what your nose weight is at the moment. Obviously, I've got the legs down at the moment, so I'll be pushing down on it.
Yeah.
Okay?
Okay.
Right, we go around this side.
Yeah.
We're a bit tight at the one because we've got two side by sides, so we've got a huge amount of space going on. We've got battery fitted, it has also got an auxiliary battery inside as well.
That's it, right, okay.
Yeah, it does want charging. Okay?
Yeah.
Also, obviously, a connection for your 240s there. This is your vent for your boiler.
Yes.
Okay? Obviously, this is your water in.
Yeah.
So it's just a pipe. If you had a whale, on your last one, it's just a pipe. The pump is actually on board.
Yes.
So this is your pipe with a filter on the end.
Yeah.
So all you do is just push it in there. There's only one way you can get it in. Just push it in. The lid will hold it in position. Don't try and pull that out without lifting the lid, because it'll pull the lid off.
Right.
Okay. All right. I don't know if you can hear that at the back. The vent. That's your heating system up and running at the moment.
Right.
Can you see that there? Look. So that's running on gas along the heating system.
Right.
So that is your exhaust for that. So obviously be careful you don't block that up.
Yeah.
You shouldn't do, but just be careful. Or don't lean anything against it. Obviously waste water out there.
Yeah.
Just be careful as you come round. Obviously it's a bit tight, then you've got cables and hose sticking out. Use your tyre
bodywork's been done.
Yeah.
There you go.
I think it's paint seal on there. Oh, well, they call it caravan bright, I think.
Yeah.
That was been done yesterday. Toilet, I'd say it should be somewhat similar. I think you've got a reservoir for the flush tank.
Yeah.
And then down here you've got a waste tank.
Yeah.
Yeah. So it's somewhat similar you had on the previous one. So this particular one, you've got handle and...
Oh, look at that. We've got a handle.
They're different.
Yeah, so the mechanism itself is the same.
Yeah.
But it's just to obviously allow you to easier to cart it off. It's the same exact mechanism, so you fill and empty through there and you
Yeah.
That's
okay.
Nice having a handler, it'd be making me do that.
Alright, well, don't you do it now?
The excuse was I couldn't carry it.
Oh, no excuse now.
Yeah, there still is.
Yeah. Right. Also, what you've all got alongside there is just
a
nice locker down there as well. Yeah. That's the step that comes with it. I've just got my step alongside at the moment.
Okay.
Yeah. Also, you've got two outlets there. One's electric for outlet and one's your gas barbecue outlet.
Yeah.
Okay. Also, very important alongside here is your wheels. Wheel nuts, you need to be checking regularly.
Yeah.
Excuse me. I just need to check. I didn't get as far as checking what the new if it's on the plate on this one. I'm going to click on it up. I'll check on the when we go inside. Yeah. It could be 110 or 130. It depends on that. We'll have a look anyway. But make sure you are checking in regularly. I will check them before you leave. Okay.
Yeah.
Ozzy, on the top here, being a very posh caravan, you've got a electronic
wind
out awning, which is this here. Obviously, you need to have a good strong battery for it, and obviously if you connect to electric. So you got self-explanatory, as in extend. You press the button,
right,
and that will extend it out. If you notice on that end there,
you got this here.
If for whatever reason it doesn't want to wind in or out, or the battery's gone flat,
there's
a little handle inside which you can wind it back manually if you're if you're stuck. Okay. You just make sure it is fully back in. Just make sure it is fully back in before you travel.
Okay. Is that just like a veranda?
Yeah, it's just
it's
like
not a got no.
It's got
support.
Legs. Yeah, it has got legs. Yeah, it has got legs. They just pull out and you just drop them down.
Right.
But just be very careful. It's windy, like it was last weekend. I was away last weekend. And if you'd have something like this, that could end up being ripped off.
Yeah.
So wind it back in if it's getting a bit breezy.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
Right. Yep. If you like to go inside.
I've forgotten what it looked like.
I know. Just be careful, obviously, the drawers out. What we got here, obviously, I've dragged everything out because, obviously, to be able to see where things are.
Yeah.
Right, so first things first, we've got a control panel.
Yep.
So you've got quite a few different switches on there. It might be something similar to what you had on your.
No.
Not.
So the one that's the silver one, you've got your master switch, 12 volts.
Yeah.
Your pump select, which I'll talk through that in a second. So interior, exterior. Pump. Master switch, voltage, so you can check your voltage on that gauge there. Also, onboard tank, so you can check the gauge, that's obviously empty at the moment. And LED lights, which is across the top of your, top of your lockers as well.
Okay.
Alright, so first things first, normally when you come into your van, you tend to get your water system up and running.
Yes.
That's the reason why I removed this drawer, because down here, if you can see, hidden down there is a yellow lever. You see that down there? Yeah, so at the moment it's horizontal, you see it. It's horizontal, it will, that's obviously closed, and what obviously stops it from draining down.
Yeah.
Okay, so that's quite cleverly hidden behind that drawer, which took me a while to find.
Yeah.
If you're going honest. So right. Otherwise, your water pump is also in there as well, which is an onboard pump.
Right.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, so put that drawer back in. So don't forget to drain that in winter, because it's quite easily forgotten being hidden behind that drawer.
Okay.
Okay. Also, what you've got is, as I said, you've got an onboard tank from them switches up there.
Yeah.
Underneath this one is a drain handle. You see this here, this grey handle. See that?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
That will pull all the way up and out. That will drain the water out.
Right.
What's the difference between that one and the yellow one?
The yellow one is draining. Is draining your boiler.
Yeah.
And your rest of your tap system.
Yeah.
Okay.
That one is just draining your onboard tank, which is under sun.
Oh, I see.
All you do is just pull the handle up.
Yeah.
It'll drain it out. Okay. So make sure if you want to use it, you need to push it all the way down.
Yeah.
You'll realise, because there'll just be water dripping out the underneath if you haven't pushed it all the way in.
Right, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Right. So, excuse me. Right, so if you want to use your water system, okay, there's options of, obviously, if you want to use your onboard tank, obviously you need to fill that first. So that's your master switch there. You need to switch master switch on.
Yeah.
You need to fill it, okay?
Right.
So that is now pumping water from outside into that tank there.
Right.
Okay, as the green indicator, if I can say the word, indicator light is saying. Obviously, that isn't your van making that racket, is the compressor at the back. Once you've filled it, you then switch it to interior, then you can draw water from the onboard tank through to your taps and through to your, through to your boiler, or if it's switched to the centre, so it says external, so you're using your water from your external source, which is your aqua.
Right.
Or if you've got direct connection from there to your tap on your pitch, which you could do.
The question I was going to mention, we obviously go to some of these superior pitches now, and I see that they have it direct to the tap, straight mains.
Yes.
I always thought
you've got to have a regulator, you should have a regulator in between that, otherwise you have full force of
that's
pressure coming in,
yeah,
it could just because the pipe that goes around your van is just push fit.
That's right.
If you have a full pressure domestic type supply, it can blow the pipes out, and you can have
a
van
full of water.
So
it's safer really having the Aquarol.
Yeah, if you have an Aquarol, what you could do direct to an Aquarol.
Yes, that's what we do normally.
Yeah, that's always a safer option. Yeah. You're just drawing more water when you need it. It's not being pressurised into
your
van.
That's right. Yeah.
Okay. So if you want to use your external source. If you switch your water pump master switch on and just leave that switch into centre, then you can draw water.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. So fill your boiler, be exactly the same as what you would have done previously.
See, I just remembered I've got the heat flat. I'm going to be really hot.
We'll come back to this in a minute. Okay. I just realised I wanted to get the heating running because I wanted to make sure the gas was up and running. Okay. Right, so to fill your boiler, it would be exactly the same as what you've done previously. All you need to do, if you've obviously filled your onboard tank, you can use it via that way or straight from that crawl. So all you do is open your taps, make sure you've got water running through. I always check I've got water through on the cold side first, so I know we've got water coming. Then change it across to the hot side, open up the tap, and once you've got a steady flow, let's see, I'll just put that in, so there's a bit of water coming through. Splutters to start with. I did manage to get some water in it. So once you've got a full flow in there, you know your onboard tank's full.
Right.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Make sure you do get all the air out.
Yeah.
So otherwise the pump will keep running for a period of time and it gets really annoying.
Yeah.
Okay.
So you're happy on that, on your water system. Do the same with each tap. Make sure you get all the air out.
Yeah.
Okay.
Right. The next one. Switch the TV off a minute. All I can hear is bits of things in my ears distract me.
Yeah.
Right, so this is your heating system, okay? This is your heating system control. On-off switch is that one there.
Yeah.
It's also, you can press that and it returns back to your main screen, which is that. Okay, anything that's red, that means that's operating.
Right.
So the first one you come to is obviously your
temperature.
Temperature, which is your heating.
Yeah.
Okay, so I press that one.
Yeah.
At the moment, I'm running it on 1,000 watts.
Yeah.
Or 1 kilowatt. I could run it on 500. Or 2,000,
or
2 kilowatts.
That was okay. Before.
Yeah, or you can have an option. Can I do that? Or operate on gas, or you can have an option of gas and electric.
Right.
So if it's really cold, gas and electric might be the one to go for.
Yeah.
2,000 watts.
We've never had to put ours.
No, it all depends on what year, what time of year you're going away. If you're going around now, it's obviously dropped a fair temperature, quite cold last night. 2,000 watts may struggle to give you enough heat.
Yeah.
It might be okay, but once you get up to temperature, it's okay.
Yeah.
So you could probably fire up on gas to start with, just to get up to temperature, then convert back to electric.
Right.
And then that'll tick over nicely and keep you warm.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah.
Well, you've also got, obviously, you've got a fan there as well. You can just have the fan running if you want to. And also your temperature. So it goes, the fan only comes on when it needs to boost the temperature into your room. So obviously I've just increased the temperature now.
Yeah.
The fan's now coming on. If it's reached temperature, you'll hear the fan die down. Okay.
So if you've got it on 600 watt and you want it on 23, does that mean that it'll take longer to get to
that? Yeah, and it might not get to that temperature.
Okay.
Because it's still, 500 watts is not a lot.
Okay.
If you imagine at home, if you've got a domestic kettle, that's probably about 2 kilowatts, 3 kilowatts, and that's just trying to heat up a little bit of water about that much.
Yeah.
So 2,000 watts.
The fan's kicked in, the lights come on. Yeah.
Yeah. Well, no, that the reason that's come on, that's because of the gas is lit.
Oh, right.
Okay, that's an indicator to say the gas is lit.
Right.
Okay, and what was the fan just for?
That's just, you can operate on fan. There, see, the gas has gone off now.
What do you mean, just
operating? Yeah, just operating a fan.
What, no heating?
Yeah, no heating, so it's just circulating air.
All right, okay.
Okay, you can have a frostat as well if you wanted to. Obviously, it's not advisable to leave it with just a frostat on. If you're leaving it over winter, just having that on, it's not going to save your... Your pipe work, if it's still got water in it, it drops to obviously well below freezing.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Or you can just have it heating off.
Yeah.
Okay. You'll find that the fan will run, if you had the heating flat out, the fan will run for a while just to cool down the system.
Down.
So don't, if you're about to go home, don't just shut everything off.
Yeah.
Allow the heating to cool down.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
Right. Next one. So you can see that now. I've switched the heating off, that's just gone.
Yeah.
Gone to the light blue, so obviously that's saying that it's not operating. The next one is your water heating.
Yeah.
So your standard water heating is just 750 watt.
Mm-hmm.
Again, that's not a huge amount of energy, so it's just 750 watt electric.
Yeah.
Once you get it warmed up, if you're going to use a shower, you may want to put it on the timed boost. Okay, so the timed boost, you can either put it on the 1500
or
or gas or both. Mm-hmm. Okay, it will do a countdown, so it will run that for 15 minutes. So I'll give you an extra hot water. You're still limited to the amount of water, which is around about 10 litres.
Yeah.
And 10 litres doesn't... it won't last that long.
How many did we have in the other one?
You probably had the same on the Truman boiler, around about 10
minutes. Yeah,
okay, so it will do a time, so it'll boost it. You'll get obviously a lot more energy. Mm-hmm. Double the electric and gas.
Okay,
is a lot of energy to heat it up. Or if you want to, so you see now that's gone red again.
Yeah, because the burner's on.
Yeah, because the gas is and that switched off. Okay, you see it's gone off again. Okay, it has also got timers as well. And it's also got.
You mean I can time when my heating's going
to
come on?
Yeah, you can set that to come on. Room timer, water timer, which you can set the clock and the other options as well.
All right. So in our other caravan, we used to have the hot water on all the time.
Yeah, it's probably just as well to do that. Okay. If you use hot water every now and again.
Yeah.
Ticking over on 750 watt, it'll keep it as a reasonable temperature.
Okay, that's fine.
Unless you use a hell of a lot of water, or you kind of if you're on a pitch and they're charging you for electric, you might want to do that. But if you're on a pitch that's if you're on a pitch that you're pay, obviously you pay for the pitch, you get electric free.
Yeah.
Well, I'll leave it running. Okay. And that's just showing you what your battery. Obviously, if you're running without electric, obviously it's very important you've got a decent battery, because otherwise, obviously the igniter runs off 12 volt.
Yeah.
If it drops below a certain voltage, I'm not sure what it is, around about 9 to 11, I think it is.
Right.
It can shut down because there's not enough voltage to actually fire it up.
Yeah.
This icon here, I'm going to just go back to that again. If I can just put room timer on. So you change it up and down.
Yeah. Right.
So I'll set that there. So now it's gone off. So I'm going to do that now. Make sure the clock is set before enabling timers. Okay, so obviously I haven't set the clock.
Yeah.
So you need to set the clock first. Okay, so obviously the clock's not set, so mm-hmm. it's just a matter of your hours or minutes and just...
Right, yeah.
It takes a while just to do that. What's it on? Are we on 13? Yeah. Obviously if you disconnect battery, obviously then the clock resets to zero. Okay, so that's now your time switched on.
Yeah.
Okay, your time switched off. Depending. If you want it to run the time, obviously you have to set the timer, then you switch it on at that point there.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
So tell me, how do I set the timer again?
Yeah, so you need to go into there, either your room timer or your water timer.
Oh, I see.
Okay.
Yeah.
And then that switches it on. Okay. It switches your timers on.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
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 Yeah.
You with that?
Yeah.
Good. Right, just one thing obviously we need to look at as well. For your electric or both, there's two isolating switches down here.
Right, yeah.
Okay. So them two there, one's for your water heater, which I think is the bottom one, and the one which is your room heater, which is sitting under there, is you isolating for your electric. So you need to switch them on for them to obviously work on electric.
That's those
you think
switches.
It would be labelled, but no.
Okay.
So that's well hidden underneath the...
Oh, are they those black switches?
Yeah, them black switches, yeah. The fuse ones,
yeah.
Right.
I don't know if I've got them, if I can't.
Yeah,
you are now,
okay.
It's right next to the two gas valves.
Okay.
Okay. So, them gas valves here, you don't need to switch them on or off. Obviously, the main one is on top of your cylinder when you're travelling.
Yeah.
They're isolating for different things, obviously. But the boiler and the heater is in that position. The other ones, I think, are under here somewhere, which is your fridge and your cooker. You don't need to switch them off there, you can do, but if you do smell gas, it's best to get out and turn it off on the cylinder anyway to cut all the gas.
Yeah.
Okay, I'll switch that. I'll switch them off one there. Right. That's it. Just stick that back under there. Right. So yeah, you're happy with that? You're happy with your control panel?
Yeah.
Yeah. Right, obviously the other things you've got, obviously the other... I'm going to trim on my slippers. Is your fridge? A little bit of fluff there. Right. If I just press that, that's actually on at the moment. If you can see, there's a little green light inside the switch. Can you see that? That's just to indicate it's on.
Right, yeah.
Okay, so digital screen. Oh, press that, it just brings that up. If you want to change anything, press and hold that. So that's set to gas.
Gas, yeah.
Okay, and that will automatically light. It will flash at you if it fails.
Yeah.
If it fails to light. As you can hear, that's lit now. And then you've got your temperature range, this, not quick enough, temperature range, so all five lit. That's the coldest setting for your fridge.
Right.
Obviously it's coming out frozen butter, then obviously it's too cold.
Yeah.
Two or three is going to be about right in this temperature in this country. Yeah. Okay? So what you've also got is auto. Yeah. So if you put it to auto, it will select the energy it thinks is the best at the time. So if you've got electric connected, it will source that. If the electric's not there, it'll source gas. If gas is not there, it'll source 12 volt, but it's not 12 volt from your van. It's actually 12 volt from your car.
Right.
Okay? So to switch it on or off, just press and hold that. That switches it off or switches it on.
Okay.
All right. All right, cooker. I'm not saying it's going to be too much different unless you didn't have an igniter on the last one. So you just press that.
Yeah.
No different. Just make sure it is cold before you bring the glass down.
Okay.
Okay. Obviously, you have got an electric one as well, which obviously indicator light to tell you there. But obviously, okay. That can shatter glass quite easily as well.
Yeah.
Okay. As I said, make sure it is cool before you bring it down. Microwave, I'm going to say nothing too complicated with the microwave. If you don't travel with glass plate in, if that drops onto this surface, likely it's going to go through it.
Yeah.
Okay. Because these are like hollow honeycomb types.
Yeah.
Okay, so it's just a matter of, he says, no, just over there, isn't it? There's actually a plug here somewhere. Oh, no, that's for the, there we go. So isolated with that's under there. You can just press start, it goes after about 30 seconds, or you can just press your hour, minutes, seconds.
Okay. It's got a metal
train. Yes, that's for a grill. Grill that.
Alright, just normally a microwave won't work with metal.
Yeah, normally it doesn't know. Okay. This type it does.
Okay.
Okay.
It's posher than me when I've got home.
Yeah, I know. So you wouldn't believe some of them are so complicated now as well. Defrost and beverage pasta. How do you know how much pasta you put in?
I don't. You just need to turn it on.
Yeah.
I don't know who
I just want to put stuff in.
That's right, I don't know who you are. Warming
beans up, that's all I want to do.
That's right, yeah.
Also, you've got extractor fan. So you've got two different settings, centres off. Also, get light.
Alright. Yeah. I'm rubbish with this video camera, he's
going to
shout at me when it's
loaded
on
YouTube. Hopefully, what my voice is, you can might be able to hopefully hear what I'm actually saying. So there is a handbook with it as well, so don't worry about that as well. Mm-hmm. Your bathroom, obviously you've got a hairdryer, which you normally don't get.
That's there, I was looking.
Yeah, be careful, I've done that a few times, I've gone to go into it, dunk it at my head, but it's that clear, you don't realise it's there. But be very careful, obviously, with the, you can see where these can go. If you go and switch the water pump on and you haven't checked to make sure that's over there and that is closed before you put water in,
right.
you could end up with water everywhere. All right?
Okay,
you might be using a hairdryer to dry the carpet then.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah. Electric flush on your toilet.
Yeah.
Okay. That's slightly different. Well.
Yeah.
I've never seen that symbol before. I'll have to have a look at the book of that. Actually, I've never seen that one on there. That's a new one.
Did we?
Yeah, but before you, I don't know if you had a manual flush or.
Yeah, no. We had a handle.
Yeah.
Has that got one?
What? No, we had electric.
Hang on.
No, we didn't. We had to open the toilet to put the loo roll down.
You are joking. You are joking. It's got an electronic to open the toilet flap.
We were the handle before.
Yeah.
I thought I'd feel a bit resistant. I cannot believe that.
Blue to swish it round and white to open.
Yeah, so blue's flush.
Yeah.
Obviously it's empty. Yeah. And that is to open up.
Yeah.
I've never seen that before.
It did say
that it had an all singing, all dancing toilet, and I've looked at it.
How can it be?
An all singing, all dancing toilet,
That is unbelievable, that is. I've seen some that have an extractor fan on them.
Yeah.
But never one that opens it on an electronic button.
Did it open it and then you had to press it to close it?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, so yeah, that opens it and shuts it.
All right, okay.
Oh, God, I knew this was a special van, but.
And I'm guessing this, Jeff, is this.
Oh, no, yeah.
Yeah,
yeah,
so
she's.
Oh!
Oh,
was that
it? It's got a
fan on the
light. Oh, I didn't know that.
I think this van, you definitely wouldn't want to run it off of it.
No.
Definitely not. If you haven't got electric on this battery, even two batteries, not going to last longer than this thing. Because it's just going to drain 12 volts down in seconds.
Okay.
Yeah. It nearly looks like wool.
It looks amazing, though, doesn't it?
It does, you know, it looks nearly real.
Really real.
Oh, so we've still got a few more other options on the roof as well.
Okay.
Yeah, so we've also got aircon and the system on the top. Right, just round the corner there, you've got your handset.
Handset, yeah.
Okay, to switch it on. But you've got isolator, which I was looking at before. That will put power to it, so as long as that's switched on.
Right.
You can switch it on via the... You've got the little button in the centre, look. Okay, so you've got options on the mode. Too quick. Right, reduce the fan a bit. So you got obviously mode button is what changes it. That's on. I don't think you see that from that angle. That's obviously cold. That's warm, so it can heat as well.
Yeah.
You have got to be very careful with the power that this will. That's just bad. The power this will use is huge. You have everything else running at the same time.
Yeah.
That bollard out there is not going to cope with the. You switch all this on, power on, heating on.
Yeah.
I'm trying to think how much they said on this now. Was it 3 or 4 kilowatt? Something like that can draw.
Yeah.
When it starts up, because it has to boost it.
Right,
same, you've got your heating down here, is a couple of kilowatts. Yeah. Heater, your boiler.
Oh, well, yeah.
So be very careful.
No heating and kettle at the same time.
Yeah, well, if that fires up, when it first fires up, it really pushes some power through it.
Right.
Okay, so that one's recycle. So if you see that emblem symbol. Okay, so that's recycling now. I'm just trying to think what was that one again? Dry air. Sorry, you got dry air. So it does show you there anyway. You know, there's all sorts of other options as well. To set your fan is with that little button there. It's your fan, so you can change the different speeds on that. Obviously, it will only set you to one. And you can also set your temperature up, plus or minus there as well. You can probably set your timer as well if you wanted to.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so you've got clock and timer set.
Yeah.
Lights as well, you can switch. Which one's the light?
Where is the light?
Yeah, that's what I'm just trying to figure out.
Well, that green light comes on.
No, that's the minute I'm on. That's just the air.
What about if we. No, there's no light there.
I'm just trying to see. It should be, usually it's around the edge.
Oh, is this a light?
Yes. Yeah.
No. I don't think it is, is it? Yeah, that's the on-off for the system.
Yeah, these are definitely lights.
Yeah, I would say that was a light.
Yeah.
You can hear it. So communicating with it, it was just no light. I know the engineer is working on this, so I was just I'll confirm him and see.
And what does this do?
Yeah, what that does is change the vent. Change the angles of your vent on the front, either blast it out or...
Right.
I see. And is this automatic?
I was going to say, that's just the window. It's not actually open, because you've got this, it's right. Just normally...
Oh.
Normally... Normally, that wouldn't be there. On this particular model, it's a posh one. You've actually got, otherwise, you would have no light coming through here.
I see.
Just a window rather than an opener.
Oh, but surely it must open, because why would you have a fire?
Look at that. I can't see it opening, to be quite honest, unless they just have fly blinds on them anyway. I'm sure that's not open, because that's not hinges, because they're locked in position both sides. There's no way it could tip by the way.
Okay.
Unless there's an option for having an openable one, perhaps, obviously not on this one.
Okay.
I'll just have to make. I'm sure that should light up. I'm not going to open it.
Mm-hmm.
I can hear it's communicating, it's just not... No, it doesn't seem to be lighting up, does it?
No.
I'll have to ask you about that.
Okay.
Alright. Also, obviously, you've got your TV.
Yeah.
Up and down there.
Ah.
That one there will take your TV up and down into the into the hydraulic. Just be careful it is all as it's going down, you make sure the cable is there. Also, just remember when you're bringing it up, there's not a glass of wine or something sitting on